Oh, hello. Yes, it's me. You know, Paul. Well, Timothy, Silas, and myself made our way to Troas because we believe that's where God wanted us to go. And while we were in Troas, I had that vision of that man from Macedonia. And in the vision, this man said, come over and tell us about Jesus. And so when I woke up from the vision, I concluded that that's where God wanted us to go. And so we also met up with another disciple, Luke. And so Luke and Timothy and Silas and myself got on a boat and we sailed across the water and to a place called, to Macedonia. And we came to a city called Philippi. It was the biggest city in the whole district. And it was, the Romans were in charge of the city, so there's a lot of Roman soldiers there. But also as we're going through the city for several days, we noticed there was no synagogue. Now, a synagogue is a building where the Jews came together regularly to worship God and to pray. But since there was no synagogue, I knew that the place of prayer would be by the river. So we went down by the river, and there we found a group of women who were worshiping and praying to God. And one of these women's name was Lydia. She was a worshiper of God. And she was from the city of Thyatira, which was across the water. But she was a businesswoman, and she sold purple cloth. Now, purple cloth was very expensive, and so she was a wealthy woman. Well, she listened to us talk about Jesus, how we talked about his life, and how he went about doing good, and that God was with him, and he did all these wonderful miracles, but that he was killed and put on a cross, and he was buried, and he rose from the dead 3 days later, and where he now rules from heaven, and he offers everyone who believes in him eternal life. We were telling her all about this, and she listened very attentively, and she decided that she wanted to be baptized. And so we were by the river there, so we baptized her and her whole household. And so when I walked her into the water, I was telling her about baptism. That baptism, we're kind of doing what Jesus did about giving up our old life, being buried, and rising up to have a brand new life that God gives us in Jesus because Jesus died on the cross. And not only do we have new life, we become part of a community that God has rescued, a community that loves us and cares for us and will always be with us. And so that's the kind of things I was telling Lydia when I baptized her. So her whole household and herself were baptized. And then she invited us back to her house. And she was very hospitable and she took care of our needs. And so it was just a great ending to a story. Lydia is a wonderful woman of God. Thank you. And we were still on our trip. And so I'll tell you more next time. So bye for now.